Myself, Dr. Hemant Kumar Jia, PG resident from AB Unison and Dr. RML Hospital, New Delhi. I am going to present a paper on role of cardiac CT in evaluation of anomalies of pulmonary veins and associated cardiac anomalies. And my guides are Dr. Munish Guleria, sir, and Dr. Sonia Sandeep, ma'am. Coming to the embryological basis, lung starts developing from 26th day of intraatrial life, during which venous drainage of the lung is to the systemic veins through pair of cardinal and umbilicovital veins. By 40th day, venous drainage of the lung loses the connection with the systemic veins as the involute and starts draining into the left atrium through common pulmonary vein. This common pulmonary vein incorporates to the left atrium as the gestation advances to form four independent pulmonary veins. Failure of loss of communication of venous drainage of the lung with the systemic vein leads to various forms of anomalous pulmonary venous return depending on the number and location of the pulmonary vein involved. This is the coronal reformatted CT image showing the normal pulmonary venous drainage pattern in which the four independent pulmonary veins are draining into the left atrium. Coming to the aims, aim of our study was to analyze the anomalous pulmonary venous return spectrum and to detect the associated cardiac anomalies. Methodology, this was a cross-sectional observational study done in a patient diagnosed with anomalies of pulmonary vein on echo or with the clinical suspicion of anomalies of pulmonary vein. Study was conducted in a tertiary care hospital, AB Unison, Dr. RML Hospital, New Delhi, India, during the period of June 2018 and August 2021. Image acquisition, retrospective ECG-gated cardiac imaging was done in 128 slice Siemens dual energy CT scanner. Coming to the results and discussion of our study, we had a total of 60 patients in our study, out of which 44 patients had TAPVC, 4 patients had PAPVC, 7 patients had sinus venosus defect, 1 patient had malposition of septum primum, 2 patients had congenital venolobar syndrome, and 2 patients had coronariatrium. Among all the spectrum of anomalies of pulmonary vein, TAPVC was the most common pattern in our study, and the malposition of septum primum was the least common type. Among 44 patients of TAPVC, supracardiac variant was the most common type, which was seen in 52% of the cases, followed by cardiac and mixed type of TAPVC. Infracardiac was the least common type of TAPVC, which was seen in 6.8% of the cases. Coming to the drainage pattern of supracardiac TAPVC, in which common chamber continuing as a vertical vein draining into the left brachiocephalic vein, which in turn draining to the SVC, was the most common pattern seen in 14 patients of supracardiac TAPVC. Common chamber continuing as a vertical vein draining into the SVC was seen in 5 patients. Left-sided veins draining to the innominate vein and the right-sided veins draining to SVC was seen in 2 patients. Common chamber draining into the right atrium via the persistent left superior vena cava was seen in 1 patient. Right-sided veins draining to the azygous veins and the left-sided veins draining to innominate vein was seen in 1 patient. In the drainage pattern of cardiac TAPVC, most common pattern was seen was common chamber draining into the right atrium via the coronary sinus, which was seen in 8 out of the 10 patients. And the common chamber or pulmonary veins individually draining to the RA was seen in a remaining 2 patients. Coming to the drainage pattern of infracardiac TAPVC, among the 3 patients of infracardiac TAPVC, common vertical vein draining to the confluence of portal and splenic vein was seen in 2 patients. Common vertical vein draining to the splenic vein was seen in 1 patient. In the drainage pattern of mixed TAPVC, left-sided veins draining to innominate vein and the right-sided vein draining to the coronary sinus and in turn draining to RA was the most common pattern, which was seen in 7 out of the 8 patients of mixed TAPVC. Right-sided veins draining to the RA, left-sided veins draining to the SVC was seen in one of the remaining patients. Coming to the partial anomalous pulmonary venous return, among the 4 patients of partial anomalous pulmonary venous return, we had 2 supracardiac and 2 cardiac PAPVC. In supracardiac, drainage pattern was of like right upper lobe veins draining to the SVC directly. And in cardiac PAPVC, right-sided veins were draining to right atrium via the coronary sinus. Among the obstructed cases of TAPVC, we had 3 obstructed cases, out of which 1 patient was of supracardiac type and 2 patients were of infracardiac type. Among 23 of the total supracardiac cases, only 1 patient of supracardiac was obstructed, constituting the 4.3% of the cases. And among the 3 patients of infracardiac TAPVC, 2 patients were of obstructed type, which constituted the 66.6% of the cases of infracardiac TAPVC. Coming to the type of the shunt, among all the patients, we had ASD as the most common pattern of shunt, which was seen in 96% of the cases, followed by the VSD, which was seen in 16% of the cases, and PDA, which was the least common shunt and seen in 3.3% of the cases. Coming to the associated cardiac anomalies, persistent left superior vena cava was the most common associated cardiac anomaly, which was seen in 12 patients, followed by pulmonary stenosis with or without the pulmonary artery hypoplasia, which was seen in 7 patients, and DORV, which was seen in 4 patients. Other associated cardiac anomalies we have encountered are single common coronary trunk, which was seen in 3 patients, complete AV canal defect seen in 2 patients, single atrial morphology seen in 1 patient, univentricular rat seen in 2 patients, coarctation of aorta with or without hypoplastic left heart syndrome was seen in 2 patients, transposition of great artery was seen in 1 patient, right-sided aortic arch was seen in 2 patients, ARSA was seen in 2 patients, aegis continuation of IVC was seen in 2 patients, deroofing of coronary sinus was also seen in 1 patient. Coming to the association of anomalous pulmonary venous return with the heterotaxy syndrome, we had 5 patients of heterotaxy syndrome among 60 cases, out of which 2 were of left-sided isomerism and 3 were right isomerism. One left isomerism patient had a cardiac TAPVC with azygous continuation of IVC. Another left isomerism patient had a cardiac TAPVC with azygous continuation of IVC and the persistent LSVC. Among the right isomerism cases, we had a cardiac TAPVC in one patient, which showed univentricular art, the double outlet right ventricle with pulmonary stenosis and right-sided aortic arch as an associated complex congenital cardiac anomaly. And right-sided isomerism with supracardiac TAPVC patient showed double outlet right ventricle with pulmonary stenosis, single coronary artery, and persistent left superior vena cava. One of the patient also showed complete AV canal defect. Coming to our cases, this was a supracardiac TAPVC in which all the pulmonary veins were joining to form a common chamber posterior superior to left atrium, which was ascending as a vertical vein and draining into the left brachiocephalic vein, which in turn was draining into SVC and right atrium. In this patient, we had ostium secundum as a shunt. Coming to the cardiac type of TAPVC, in which all the pulmonary veins were joining to form a common trunk. This common trunk was draining to the right atrium via coronary sinus, and this coronary sinus also showed deroofing into the left atrium. There was also a small ostium secundum ASD in this patient. Coming to the infracardiac TAPVC, in which this case showed all the 4 pulmonary veins joining to form a descending vertical vein, forming the Fertri pattern, which was draining to the confluence of portal vein and the splenic vein, and this patient also had a ostium secundum ASD as a shunt. Coming to the mixed TAPVC, in which cardiac and supracardiac type was seen in our case, where left superior lobar and lingular segmental pulmonary veins were draining into the left innominate vein, left lower and the right-sided pulmonary veins were forming the common chamber. This common chamber was draining into the right atrium via the coronary sinus. And once again, ostium secundum was seen as a shunt in this patient. Coming to the sinus venosus defect, this is a defect in the posterior superior wall of the left atrium, which separates the right atrium and SVC junction from the left atrium. In this defect, the right upper lobe pulmonary veins will be unroofed into the SVC, and this SVC overrides the sinus venosus defect, and it will be committed to the both atria. Coming to the malposition of septum primum, in this case, we had leftward deviation of the posterior interatrial septum, leading to the drainage of the right-sided pulmonary veins into the right atrium and the left-sided veins into the left atrium. This was a case of coronary atrium, in which all pulmonary veins were joining to form a common atrium, common chamber behind the left atrium. This common chamber was draining into the distal chamber through a non-restrictive opening, suggestive of Loeffler's type 3 coronary atrium. And this patient also had DTGA, in which aorta was seen anterior and to the right of pulmonary artery, and also perimembranous outlet VSD seen in this patient. Coming to the congenital venolobar syndrome or type G pulmonary malinasculation. In pulmonary malinasculation, we can have either pulmonary artery, vein, or lung anomalies. Type G will have all 3 components, which was seen in our case, in which inferior pulmonary vein was draining into the suprahepatic IVC. There was a right lung hypoplasia and the hypoplastic pulmonary artery. This patient also had ostium secundum ASD as the shunt. Coming to the right isomerism, this was a case in which liver was centrally located and the bilateral bronchus showed right-sided morphology with trilobed lungs and common atrium with a complete AV canal defect, persistent left superior vena cava, double outlet right ventricle with the pulmonary stenosis, having the bilateral subarterial conus and the single coronary artery arising from the posterior facing sinus. And this patient had a supracardiac TAPVC. This is the common chamber ascending and draining into the superior vena cava. Coming to the left isomerism, here also liver was centrally located with multiple lobulated spleens. This is the polysplenia, and the bronchus showing the bilateral left-sided morphology with the bilobed lungs. And here right-sided veins were draining to the right atrium and the left pulmonary veins were draining to the left atrium. This patient also had a persistent left superior vena cava and IVC interruption with azygous continuation of IVC. Coming to the conclusion, TAPVC was the most common anomalous pulmonary venous drainage followed by sinus venosus defect. Malposition of septum primum was the least common pattern. Supracardiac was the most common and the infracardiac was the least common type of TAPVC. Infracardiac TAPVC was the most common cause of obstructed TAPVC. ASD was the most common shunt in association with anomalous pulmonary venous return. Among the associated cardiovascular anomalies, persistent LSVC was the most common followed by pulmonary stenosis and DORV. Anomalous pulmonary venous return when associated with the heterotaxis syndrome show either other complex congenital cardiac anomalies. Cardiac CT is an excellent modality for complete evaluation of anomalous pulmonary venous return and associated cardiac anomalies. This is my reference.